My father was farming since I was still young. It was my dream to become a farmer. Livestock is like your children. You have to look after them carefully every day. When I bought the farm, I knew that there was a mine which was not in use. I took some water and gave it to my livestock, and then they died. Then I realized that the water is poisonous. There is an open area where no grass, no trees, it's just pitch black. The mine, which is not rehabilitated, it's very dangerous because there is always acid in the water.
It is really disturbing because it's almost about 30 hectares which I can't utilize, you see. There's nothing that I can do, yeah.
A cousin called wants to come back and mine at this area, but I'm very worried. I don't trust those people. They used to come to my place without my permission.
I just see a buggy standing here without my permission. I don't know whose buggy is this and where the owners are. I don't know. We'll have to check them. Hi. Why are you here for?
I'm going to collect the sample.
Permission. Where did you get the permission?
The what?
Where did you get the permission? The permission.
The permission?
Yeah.
There's a court order.
Guys, according to my lawyer, you're not allowed to be here. Then I'm going to charge you for trespassing.
That this is my mine and we are going to mine here. I'll do you a deal. I want my sample, and I won't come here. I'll say it on proof, on your cameras, whatever. And I won't come back here unless I haven't got the necessary documents. Is that a deal?
A deal with the main. Gegaan. Sonder my toestemming, give it.
Yeah, I could you gesê.
Sorry, can you speak English?
That's
what I told him.
No. This is the thing that I had in my life.
Yeah, I could you gesê.
Yeah, no. I had that in my life.
Country needs coal. I'm not against the mining, but what is needed, the community must be involved, well informed, and all the procedures must be followed accordingly. Elias took me to the community's houses and showed me how the people were affected by the mining.
Since 2006 when we started the crisis committee.
Okay.
Yeah, we started the crisis committee because of the mining that was doing these damages to our houses.
This is a massive one.
Yeah, it's very difficult.
From top to the bottom.
The time they are blasting it started to make this.
Okay.
As you can see now, the whole ceiling has shifted because of this wall that is moving. At some stages, it is a one kick which is so strong. To an extent that even the shaking happens to us in the house here. Mm. Only one person, two people who came once here telling me that they are from Mpumalanga mine. And they also promised to come back after they've seen this and they never came back.
Before they started the mining, did they consult you?
Never.
People and the community?
They never consulted us.
Okay.
Nobody consulted us.
This is a mine that have caused those damages
in those houses where we're coming from. You can even see how closer it is to this residential area. And these houses were built before the mining started to mine.
Don't you think that it's very dangerous to the kids playing in this area?
I think it is very much dangerous because this soil is underground soil, so we don't know how acidic it is. It just can go through their nose and ears. This situation which happened at Wessleton should not be cascaded to other locations. My advice would be that they should not allow this situation because there's nothing that we can point and say, because of this mining, we benefited here. We never benefited anything.
South Africa is so beautiful. Any damage is made, we need to repair before it's too late. Mining and farming can do better by working together with the community in this country. They must work hand in hand. This land belongs to all of us in this country.